Hey guys, what's going on? My name's Eric and today I'm reviewing Avicii's third album, Tim, which just came out a few days ago. As we all probably know, it's a posthumous album following his death back last year in April. And I wanted to say before I just get into this that, first of all, I want to be very respectful of the fact that this is a posthumous album. I think when you're critiquing someone's work after they've died, you're getting into some very touchy territory. I mean, it's okay if you're reviewing work, you know, like years and years after someone's passed and, you know, you can kind of, you're a bit more removed from it then, but I know this is still very fresh in a lot of people's memories. You know, it's only been a year and a bit since Avicii's suicide. So yeah, I'm gonna just try and be very respectful of that. At the same time, I wanna be honest, you know, I don't like to pretend. I think there's still a way to give your thoughts in a respectful manner. So anyway, let's get into it. So I think the first thing that struck me about this album is how much more personal it is to Tim compared to his previous albums. If you really dissect the lyrics, you really discover a lot of nuance between this kind of light and shade throughout every song. The songs from their immediate perspective might appear to be melancholic or even alarming. You know, we have the debut single from this album, which was SOS. Obviously that sounds like a depressing kind of song, but it also has a bit of optimism in it, you know, this idea of having your mind put at peace by someone you love. Certainly that's a common theme throughout the album. Even the song before that, Heaven, you know, has this idea of dying but going to heaven. And while upon first listening, you might just think that, you know, it's just about discovering yourself in paradise, you know, you've died and gone to heaven. Knowing obviously under the circumstances of what happened to Avicii in the last year, you know, it's quite likely that there's some more deeper meaning to that. I think that's probably this album's biggest strength, is not only is it very personal to Avicii, hence why, you know, the album's probably called Tim, but it's also very human. The songs aren't just about emotional extremes, you know, the emotional highs and emotional lows. It's all about the nuance in between and how both these highs and lows interact with each other. And this is something I think that is very inherently human. You know, we don't just have these extreme emotions. You know, we often have this middle ground of just confusion and trying to understand our emotions for ourselves. And that's really what a lot of these songs are about. They're dissecting, I think, Tim's own emotions. And by extension, just of how personal that is, I think a lot of people will relate to the humanistic approach on this album. It feels like this album really achieves Avicii's ultimate goal. I feel like, you know, Avicii's music, I always felt, had a bit more character than the everyday dance EDM music. You could really feel with all of Avicii's songs up to this point that, you know, he wasn't just reading the instruction manual of how to make a progressive house track or anything like that. His songs really came from the heart. They really came from a sense of passion. And you could just hear that in all of his songs. But I feel like this album especially is just really fulfilling that goal Avicii had. At least as far as the lyrics go, as far as production goes, well, let's discuss that a little bit. Now, I don't think there's any doubt that as far as production quality goes, this album just comes on top out of Avicii's three albums. All throughout the album, there's so much sonic depth going into the sound design. And I think that's probably owed to the use of a lot of acoustic instruments. You're gonna hear a lot more acoustic guitar, I feel like, which is almost like an homage to Avicii's first album. The second album, you know, Stories, I don't know if that had as much acoustic guitar. Perhaps that album was slightly more piano focused, which is obviously, you know, Avicii's main instrument. But we have a lot of acoustic guitar in this album as well as some orchestral instruments that pop up in a few tracks. And I think this addition of acoustic instruments just gives a lot more character to what would otherwise be a predominantly, you know, electronic sound. But at the same time, that's not like some hack to make this album just sound better than it actually is. There is a genuine improvement into the production quality of the electronic sounds in this music as well. Particularly as far as the plucks go in some of the more trappy songs, I definitely feel like there's a lot more detail in those sounds. It's almost like he's swapped synths or something. Like, I know he used to use Silence a lot. Some of these sounds almost sound like they were made in Serum. You know, just a synth that is a little bit more robust, maybe. Whatever it is, I just noticed with some of these drops that the electronic sounds even sound a little bit more organic, which is a nice compliment to the acoustic instruments in these songs. Now, as far as the songs themselves go and my personal just enjoyment of them, look, I've got to be honest, and this is really hard to say again because I know this is a really touchy topic. It's, you know, a posthumous album and it's still very much on our hearts and minds about, you know, Avicii's death. And I purposely put off reviewing this album as soon as it came out because I really wanted to make sure that my feelings about these songs were genuinely, like, realistic once I recorded them on camera. Because I know last time when I reviewed Stories, my opinions kind of changed on some of the songs that I, you know, reviewed in that review way back. I think there's definitely such a thing as a slow burn when it comes to music. And sometimes when there's so much hype around an album, then the first time you hear it, you have this, you know, wild expectation that you're just gonna have these emotional extremes, almost like I mentioned before. And then when you just don't get all of that instant gratification and hype, then it leaves you feeling disappointed. But later down the track, as you listen to those songs with less hypeful expectation, if that's a word, you know, when you're just in the car or going for a walk and, you know, you just pop it on, you kind of start enjoying it more. And I know this definitely happened, as I said, with Avicii's Stories. Also happened a little bit more recently with Don Diablo's Future album. Not all of these songs are made for the dance floor. You know, some of them are just made for like everyday listening, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. I have to say though, and it kills me to say it, but some of the songs throughout the middle of the album I did find kind of fit into a kind of pop formula that is very familiar and isn't really breaking a lot of new ground. But I want to stress that's really throughout the middle of the album. I'm not talking the whole album. In fact, as soon as the album opens up on that first song, it's very hopeful and it's very uplifting, and I really liked where that was going for that first little bit of the album. Following that, obviously a fan favorite, Heaven, which is kind of a throwback to some of Avicii's older style of music. And you can certainly hear that. I think that song was produced a few years ago, possibly before even Stories came out, which is crazy. I think what makes that song so great is just how classic it sounds. You have that signature Avicii ARP melody going throughout it. And then obviously Chris Martin's vocals on top of that just bring it to another level. And this era of the album was a real high point. After that, we had the two songs that are being released as singles, SOS, which I've already talked about, and Tough Love. So SOS took a little bit more of a pop formula, but I think of all of the kind of more poppy, traditional, formulaic tracks on this album, SOS, that was the one that really drove it home for me. As I was saying before about how the plucks in some of these songs sound very organic, this was one of the songs I was referring to. The drop almost doesn't even sound entirely electronic because of just how organic that pluck sound is. It just sounds like someone's hitting some kind of tonal percussion instrument almost. Tough Love following that, obviously another single release before the album's release. What I love about this song is how it's still kind of able to fit into a kind of pop formula, but also simultaneously try something new, which is sort of what I try to aspire to, I guess, when I'm writing music myself. As you probably heard, the drop has a very East Asian sound to it, I suppose. It almost sounds like Avicii's collaborated with Kashmir or something. But the fact that he's been able to take that and then turn it into like this commercial pop song is really a testament to his creative ability, I think. So for me, this is round about the point. For me, my personal opinion, this is round about the point where I think the song has dipped a little bit in quality. There's a decent enough song following this called Bad Reputation. It has a bit of a rhythmic drop and it might just get you tapping your hands on your legs as you listen to it. But I just found from here on, all throughout sort of the middle of the album, it just kind of fell into a little bit more formulaic territory, as I mentioned before. I think it was mostly the two songs after that that make me say this, like Ain't A Thing and Hold The Line. Both sound unique enough sonically as far as sound design goes, especially in the drops. I just think as far as chord progressions go and the melodies even, it's nothing really that cutting edge. Things start improving a little bit after those two songs with Freak and Excuse Me, Mr. Sir. Freak, while by no means a really ambitious track, at least has a slight departure from the formula that the previous tracks had established. Freak just kind of mixes things up a little bit with the sound design, which keeps things fresh. Structure, it's fairly similar, so it's still not like a highlight of the album for me personally. But again, it keeps improving. Following that, we have Excuse Me, Mr. Sir, which reintroduces the acoustic guitar. Again, adds a lot of character. Once again, there's a lot of depth in the sound of the plucks in the drop. They sound very organic, which really complements the acoustic guitar. I also found the acoustic guitar in this track was quite rhythmic, which was complemented by the plucks in the drop, which stuck to that kind of similar rhythm. I think the rhythm just felt very real. It was almost like someone was playing that rhythm, you know, as opposed to just plotting it out as a MIDI. I gotta say though, after that, this album just absolutely steps up a notch. We have a song with Imagine Dragons, or at least the vocalist from Imagine Dragons, I've got his name. And I love how ambitious this track is. Honestly, it's like Avicii just said, you know what, forget about the pop formula. I'm gonna do my own thing now. The structure is very unpredictable. You have no idea where it's going, which is very exciting. I think what really sells this track though are those strings, man. I think like a lot of other songs in this album, the song really matches the style of Avicii's collaborator, in this case, Imagine Dragons. It has a very epic feel to it. And as I was saying, that's really owed to the strings. You just notice as soon as they're kicking, it just adds this cinematic vibe. You know, I'll go as far as saying this is probably one of the most powerful songs I've heard this year. And I listen to a lot of music. Back with the camera now, sorry about that. So where were we? Right, second last song after the Imagine Dragons song. Obviously not as good because the Imagine Dragons song was my favorite song. This one's still nice though, it's called Never Leave Me and is a little bit more low key. Takes a little bit more of a plucky synth approach, which is kind of a throwback to Avicii's old style. Yeah, it certainly beats the middle of the album, I think, but again, it's just not as good as that first little section or some of these tracks in the last section, like the final track, which I really liked. This one's called Fade Away and it uses a muted kind of piano sound along with some very pretty vocals. And all that sort of builds up to a drop which uses these really vibrant strings. And I think that was a really wise decision because when you have a really delicate sounding song, you don't want to just ruin it with this really obnoxious sounding synth in a drop. You need something that's equally as pretty, and the drop is still, you know, relatively upbeat and but it's hopeful and it's pretty and it's like beautiful. And it was also fitting to close the album on, being called Fades Away. Lyrically it makes a bit of sense there. Anyway, I should probably wrap this up. I think probably this album's biggest strength, I would have to say, is the lyrics. The words, there's a lot of nuance, there's a lot of thought that's gone into those words. They're quite emotionally deep and can be interpreted in a lot of ways, which really encourages multiple listens and is a nice compliment to your own life journey. But at the end of the day, I think this really is an album about Tim and the things that he was going through, the things that were going through his mind, through all their complexities, and really that is something that on one hand is quite eerie, on another hand is quite fascinating, but I think more important than that is something that really needs to be heard. As far as pure songs go, in like structure and, you know, chord progressions and all that jazz, I would say Avicii's previous two albums are stronger in that regard. But as far as sound design, sonically, this album is definitely a big step up. But those are my personal thoughts, so let me know what your thoughts are down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit subscribe and the bell button, wherever that is. And also stay tuned because I'm going to be doing a piano tutorial for that last song on the album, Fades Away, which will be up very soon. So stick around for that. But until then, I'll see you all later. Ciao.